Hello everyone and welcome to another Affinity Designer tutorial, Creating Patterns. A three-part lesson starting with drawing the pattern, working inside the expert persona, and apply a bitmap pattern fill using the fill tool. Alright, inside Affinity Designer with a blank new document, I will go ahead and change its canvas size to square dimensions since we are creating a pattern. So I will tap on the document menu and then tap to resize. And at the bottom of the context toolbar, I'm going to set this to canvas. I will tap to unlock the aspect ratio. I'm going to set the width to 1200 and the height also to 1200. And for units of measurements, I will set this to pixels. And then I was just going to apply that. Great. Now, again, inside the document menu, I will tap on the grid, tap to show the grid, set the grid mode to standard, and I will change the spacing to 50 pixels. Great. So the first shape that I will create, it will be basically just a circle. And all I'm going to do is just tap and drag to create just a random circle. I will switch to the Move tool. I will tap inside the Transform Studio. And inside the dimensions, I'm going to set this numerically to 1,000 by 1,000 pixels. And then all I'm going to do is just center this into the canvas. All right. No need to have any fill, just the stroke color is okay. And I've set the stroke to 1 point, which is also fine. Great. Now I'm going to switch to the pen tool and I will create a straight segment right across, right in the center. So tap to create the first node and tap to create the second node. And here is the first straight segment, which I will go inside the edit menu, tap to duplicate this, tap inside the Transform Studio, and then rotate this to 90 degrees. I will duplicate this again and rotate this to 45 degrees. Tap to create another duplicate and rotate that also to 45 degrees, like so. All right, great. So basically we have the first group here. So what I'm gonna do is I will use the Move tool and I will marquee select everything. And inside the Layer Studio, I will tap on the group icon to create the first group. And then I will tap on the layers options, tap to lock, so I don't accidentally move this layer. Great. Now we are ready to go to create some more shapes. In this case, I will go ahead and use the rectangle tool and I will create a bunch of square shapes. So I will tap and drag to create the first one here, which I will rotate this to 45 degrees. Make sure this is in place and make sure also you're on the Move tool. Tap to create more duplicates and more duplicates. All right. I'm going to rotate this back to zero. Move it to place and create some more squares. Like so. All right. So this is the second group. So I will marquee select all of these squares and rectangles. And again, inside the Layer Studio, I will tap to group those. Here is the second group. Again, I will make sure that I lock this group so I don't accidentally move anything. All right. Let's go to create some more shapes. So I will switch to the pen tool and I will create a bunch of segments here, straight segments, to create a shape as such. Actually, this should be a closed shape, a closed path, and I'm double checking my work. Indeed, it is. So I will duplicate this, rotate it, move it into place, select those two, tap on the edit menu, create the first duplicate, rotate this by 45 degrees, create another duplicate, and create another duplicate. Great. Now, I need to actually create a cut around all of these curves with the circle. So what I'm trying to say is that I need to have a duplicate of the initial ellipse circle that I used. So I will tap on that, tap to duplicate this, and then tap and hold to bring this outside the group here. Marquee select everything, and inside the edit menu and inside the geometry, I would use the third Boolean operation, which is the intersect Boolean operation. There we go. Now, everything is under one curve, as you can see here. There you go. So basically what I need to do now is I need to separate those curves to individual curves to be able to color them. So I will go back to the edit menu and then tap on the separate curves function like so. And we can see now all of these individual curves inside the Layer Studio. So I will spend a bit of time here to color all of these shapes and get ready for the next step, which is the export persona. All right, I completed coloring all shapes. Now we'll go ahead and merge everything into one group to be able to export just one layer. So inside the Layer Studio, I will swipe to the right, swipe to the right, and swipe to the right to select all these groups, and then tap on the group icon to group everything. I'm also going to size everything down to, let's see, 200 pixels. There we go. And now I'm ready to tap on the export persona. So I will go ahead and do that. And here I will be using the Layers Studio to create slices from layer content, which means take contents and turn them into slices. So how do we do that? Well, instead of using the default slice tool, I will tap on the slice selection tool and tap on the Layer Studio. And with the right layer selected, in this case, we only have one layer, we're going to tap to create slice, like so. Now that shows up as a slice inside the Slices Studio. Now in this case, I will not be exporting the background, so I would toggle off its visibility. And let's see, let me zoom in here a bit and talk about the slice switch window, which gives us the dimensions, the default name slice one, the export option, which is set right now to PNG, the RGB color space, and the bit depth of 8. So a couple of things to consider here. I will tap on the slice options. First of all, I will go ahead and rename slice one to pattern. There we go. And next we have a plethora of presets that Affinity Designer provides for us. And actually this is a great list, and I highly recommend you experiment with that, of course, depending your own project. Then we have the addition of increased level of resolution. In this case, we have 1x, 2x, and 3x. We can also have all of them at the same time. In this case, I'm just going to use the 3x. And then one more thing I would like to bring to your attention is that inside the preferences here, we can actually choose where our slice would be exported. So in other words, we can choose the export folder of our choice. I have already done that, and only thing I'm going to do is tap to export the pattern, the slice here. All right, back on the Designer Studio. Now I will draw a simple shape and fill this shape with the pattern. So I will go ahead and grab the rectangle tool. I'm going to go ahead and just draw one like so. And then let's see, no need to have any stroke. Fill will be okay. Actually, the color doesn't really matter. I'm just going to set this to white because we are going to fill this with the pattern. In any case, I will go back to the document menu, tap on the grid, and I will toggle off the visibility of the grid as well. All right, great. So let's go ahead and fill this rectangle with a pattern. So for that, we will go ahead and grab the fill tool. And at the bottom of the context toolbar, we have all these options under the type, which I'm going to cycle through and set this to the bitmap option. And that brings us the space where the export files have been saved. In this case, I would use the pattern 3x, and here is the pattern. Now that gives us immediately a couple of fill handles to rescale or rotate. And we can do this from either handles, right? So this is one thing. Another thing is, as you can see, this center circle here, we can grab it and we can move it around and place the bitmap image in a certain location around, but within this shape. So I will go ahead and size this down a bit. And as I do, by the way, let's look inside the Layer Studio. We can see the original group here. So I will toggle off its visibility. That's one thing. Another thing that to bring to your attention is that right now we are transforming proportionally. So if you want to do this disproportionately, go ahead and tap on the aspect icon to turn off the maintain aspect ratio and perhaps stretch the pattern on either axis independently. In this case, I will tap to undo this and then again tap on the aspect icon. So all I'm going to do is just scale this down quite a bit to my liking. Make sure this is at the very center and this is going to snap. There you go. I believe we're in good shape here. So another thing we can do is we can tap on the document menu and then just tap to export this to different file formats. All right. So I'm going to cancel that out. And all you have to do is just experiment around the shapes and come up with your own patterns that you can use for so many different projects and design ideas. Thank you everyone for visiting my channel and spending time with me, watching the inspiring lectures and project tutorials. Do not forget to subscribe and share the knowledge.